August 18th, it's about 9:38 now. This Sony is cut off on me three times, so just I'm going to get to up front because if it shuts off again, I'm going to get pissed off and just stop. Been taking everything up now because I got beans planted in the back. The only thing that's left in the back, there's some melon right there. It's like honeydew and some cantaloupe. I'm going to pull up some more yet because they overtook the cherry tomatoes. I didn't know I had cherry tomatoes. I thought they were just a small tomato, not a cherry tomato, which is even smaller. And they overtook them. But I've tore up all the others, burned most of them. That's cucumber right there. There's a couple small cucumbers on there. That's the only reason they're out there. So although I did went ahead and plant beans, I planted two seeds in each hole and then eight holes for each type of bean and pea, mainly beans. These purple hull peas I'm going to plant back in the back too. So for the fall, we'll have beans and peas going on this back number three garden. I got four fences up. I call them my poor man fences. All it is chicken wire with tomato steaks through them to hold them up. That's all I got. Just because I want everything to be as crude as possible. Because, you know, folks, I'm not trying to be one of those conspiracy theorists. But, you know, when everything kind of collapses, at least you'll have some idea of what to do and how to do it. And I've got these makeshifts, you know. So instead of going out and buying this and buying that and having a perfect little garden, this to me, I've always called this my survival garden because my wife and I have come out here, put plastic down, thanks to Andy. He happens to be the commissioner of the roads commissioner for the Crockett County. He's also our mail carrier. But, he got us this plastic from a farmer and we've used it for 3 years, 4 years now, cut it up. This is one big giant bag we've cut. This one here in the back is about 60 feet across from east, that's east, to west. And it's about 34 feet from south here to north right there. And we've had different stuff back there. But this year we're going to, like I say, I planted a bunch of beans and peas. This is all going to come up. Right there were some cherry tomatoes there that you can see they're all debilitated or whatever. They're not doing so well. Worms got on some of those. The leaves are all eat off. Most of them got pieces of tomato eat. But we got these cantaloupes and stuff all around them. So it's come all the way over here. You know, 1, 2, 3, 4. Well, that one just started. We had three good tomato plants. They started sprawling out. I just cut the strings off them that had them all bunched up so they could just lay down. And they're small. They're between a pool ball and a baseball size. Mainly closer to the pool ball size, though, small. Almost a little bit bigger than a golf ball, I should say. Tomatoes. But, see, that one right there was a small one. That one's finally getting some tomatoes on there. One in the back, I'm going to end up taking that one down. It's got two tomatoes on it that they're not doing with a damn. But that one right there is a newer one that started blooming out. That one right there, I have to get it restaked a little bit. And one in the back on the edge. Now it's starting to sprout up, so I want to reinforce it with a thick tomato stake that's laying there on the plastic. And we'll see if we can get any tomatoes for the last, into October. Because our growing temperatures will go into November, roughly. So these cucumbers are going to come up probably be in about another week or two. And I've got beans, heirloom beans all in here. Not every row. I have three rows of eight holes. I mean, 1, 2, 3, 4 holes with two beans in each one. And then I have two rows. We have three holes with two beans in each of those, so 6, 12. But originally I was doing this, but the camera, like I said, being a Sony, kept shutting off. Look at the squash bugs on this. That's what killed all these zucchini. Not all of them, but they were starting to before. We got a lot of good-sized, big zucchini and everything. And I decided to go ahead and just tear them down. And you see those are your squash bugs. If you see, like, little speckles, look like BBs or something on a leaf, it looks almost like little metal balls. Those are eggs for those things. You take the leaves and burn them. I gotta get out of here because they're getting on my feet. Look at them on the grass and everything. Shit. God. Yeah, they're getting on everything. You can see that right there, that white one. Now it'll start itching. But yeah, that's your squash bug. That's what gets on there. It'll decimate them. Look at it. See, I just started turning them up and all that. So I'd say 95% of this is from me tearing them down. But now you see the bugs all over them too. The eggs have hatched and they're getting on the plant. They shouldn't do anything with beans. I don't know if they would go all over there and get on my little bit of cantaloupe and honeydew that I'm going to tear up in a couple days here. But that's squash bugs. Thousands of them. Look at them. Yeah. All right, focus. It is a Sony. See if it shuts off. See all that? Yeah. All over it, like I say, it's even on the grass right in there. I showed you a couple. It's all over the dead one, all the dead squash here. Okra. I don't know if we cut it today, yesterday. Gotta get some green okra off of here. About 2 inches. Yeah, these are about 2 and 3 inches. See, that's a pepper plant. That's a little bit bigger than it was when we planted it down there. And look at it. There's one in the back there that's growing. This year, that's the best the peppers have done all year. Anyway, you see the okra up there. Right in the center. I'm just holding the camera rather than zooming in and out because it'll probably shut off again and again. It is a Sony. See the burgundy okra right here. That's about 3 inches long. Look at that long one there from not being cut. That could be one day left on. It should have been cut off yesterday morning. That's how it gets. That's about 7 inches right there. There's a bunch about this 3-inch, 4-inch size right here. But you'll itch like crazy when you do this too. So I got a bucket of black-eyed peas and purple hull peas, which I'm going to plant a couple of those after I get them melons up over there tomorrow or the next day. So, depending on the rain, too, because we had storms. There's look at that giant one. I'm going to zoom in. I got to zoom in because I'm not going in there. Getting all itchy. If I can see that on here. There's a giant okra in there. That's... I got that squash bug. I got them on my foot and squished them. I squashed them, get it? But, I can't see it on there. This viewfinder sucks, folks. That's why Sony's got this crap out there. So you really can't see what you're doing well. But there's a big burgundy okra in there. It's probably about 9 inches long or bigger. Right in the center. And again, I don't know if it's coming out on there. I think that's it in the center. And zoom in and zoom back out to focus. Come on. You'll have to take my word for it. It's about 9 inches long. It's a big burgundy okra. It looks like a dagger almost. But, yeah, these got to be picked this afternoon. The green ones are the ones I prefer. We only planted one, well, two. There's a small one growing on the corner. Right over here. And that's all been cut off because it's easy to get to. That's the thing, too. See, some of them, if they're easy to get to, you'll be surprised how easy those get cut off right away. So here's a long burgundy one. This is smaller than the one that's in there. This is about 6 inches, maybe 7 inches long. And the one that's in there, like I say, it's about 3 or 4 inches tall. Longer than that, it might be 10 inches long. Whew, man. It's humid out here. It's not hot, it's humid. And the sun. Sun is kind of strange. It feels hot, that sun does. And again, people know sun is hot. Yeah, I understand, but it's different, folks. Trust me. I've been outside my entire life. This year and last year, this year more than last year even, but last year, it's been very uncomfortable heat. See, on this side, I don't know if you can see that oak right in the middle.